Hey, hi, welcome back to Millets TV. In this video, we will talk about the history of millets. Most of us think the millets that people are talking about these days is something new that is coming up. But in fact, millets have been for the ages and been our food, and that got forgotten gradually as we shifted our focus towards fast food, sugary and junk foods, causing hell lot of health problems to the entire humanity. In ancient days, people in India and other parts of the world used millets as their main food and stayed healthy and strong. The term millets is applied to various grass crops whose seeds are harvested for food and feed. They are mostly tiny in size, round in shape, and varies in color. Millet is one of the oldest human foods and believed to be the first domesticated cereal grain. Though it is difficult to know the exact origin, it is widely accepted that the millet was domesticated and cultivated simultaneously in Asia and Africa over 7,000 years ago during the Neolithic era and then spread throughout the world as a staple food. It was a staple food of the Sumerians. Also, millets was a treasured plant grown in the hanging gardens of Babylon. There is enough evidence that millet was grown during the Stone Age by lake dwellers in Switzerland and was eaten in Northern Europe at least since the Iron Age. It was staple food in arid areas of India and Africa for thousands of years. Millet was the prevalent grain of China before rice. In 2005, in northwestern China, archaeologists unearthed a perfectly preserved 4,000-year-old bowl containing long yellow noodles made from foxtail millet. Foxtail millet is also known as Italian or German millet. Early Egyptians learned how to grow millet in arid Sahara around 3000 before Christ. It was grown in southern Arabia as well and in what once was called Gaul, now it is France. The Romans called millets as millium. The Hansa people living in the remote Himalayan foothills and known for their extraordinary health and longevity just by enjoying millet as their main staple food. Many types of millet have been found in Harappa and Mohenjo-daro archaeological sites. Indian Vedic scriptures like Satapada Brahmana have ample references to millets. Kalidasa, in his legendary literary masterpiece Shakuntala, has said Kanva pouring foxtail millet while bidding farewell to Shakuntala in Dushyanta's court. Millet was even mentioned in the Hebrew Bible. The great explorer Marco Polo wrote about food under the rule of Genghis Khan. He mentioned, "They have no shortage of food because they mostly use rice and millet as their main food. Especially the Tatars and the people of Cathay and Manzi, they do not use bread, but simply boil this sort of grain." The Western European emperor Charlemagne ordered millet to be stored and used as a Lenten food. During the Middle Ages, millet was the main staple grain in Europe and grown more widely than wheat. Millets have been a good part of the staple diet among many communities across the world for ages. In some sort of form, millets was popping up in literature, sculptures, paintings, folk songs, and religious compositions, mythological stories from different times and geographies. When compared to other cereal grains, millets do not ask much from the soil. Instead, they are rain-fed and are not susceptible to pests either in the field or during storage. Considering how likely it would be that early humans would be able to access dry, rain-fed lands as compared to wetlands, it becomes apparent that millets would be the go to the grains to meet dietary needs. In fact, as we move forward in time, we see that as agricultural communities were able to avail of irrigation, more and more of them have lost out on their millet heritage. Even until 50 years ago, millets was the major grain grown in India. From a staple food to integral part of local food cultures, just like many other things, millets have come to be looked down upon by modern urban consumers. Now, with growing health consciousness, environmental concern, and the pressing need for updating our food systems to survive climate change, millets, probably the earliest of cereal grains that humans started domesticating, are making a real comeback. Although its role has diminished, today millets rank as the sixth most important cereal grain in the world, sustaining more than one-third of the world's population. China, India, and Niger are the world's largest growers of millets today. So, now we understood millets are not something new. It's been as our main food for ages. Now, it is time again for us to start eating this wonderful grains called millets. If you think the video is useful, please like and share with your friends and families and make them aware of millets. Also, please don't forget to subscribe to Millets TV. Thank you.